Bluehost or HostGator, which one is better? Or more importantly, which one is better suited to you? In this video, I will put them both to the test and compare them against each other. And the five categories that I will be comparing them on are pricing, setup and ease of use, speed and uptime performance, support, and features. Pricing. I will determine who has the best price and what is included in those pricing plans. Setup and ease of use. I will show you who has a more intuitive user interface and who makes it easier to set up and manage your website. Speed and uptime performance. I will test which hosting provider is faster and more reliable. Support. I will ask questions from their customer support team to determine who is more responsive and helpful. And lastly, features. I will compare the features of those two hosting providers to determine who has more and better features overall. At the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up Bluehost or HostGator through my link below. I'm going to give you my six-figure blogger course for free as a bonus and just a way of saying thank you for supporting my channel. In this course, I show you how to set up your WordPress website the right way, how to adjust and tweak settings for optimal website performance, and how to start driving traffic and make money from your site. Now let's get straight into this review. To make it fair, we are just going to compare their normal price with no extra special discount. I have done individual reviews on each hosting provider, which I will leave in the description, where you can purchase it at an extra discount once you have decided which hosting provider is right for you. Let's compare the cheapest plan first for each of the hosting provider. This one is going to be really close, as Bluehost's basic plan for 3 years costs $2.95 per month, while HostGator's Hatchling plan will set you back $2.75 per month. This means that HostGator is 7% cheaper, which is very small. If we compare their 1 year plan though, Bluehost will cost $4.95, while HostGator will cost just $3.95, which shows a bigger difference here as Bluehost is now 20% more expensive. So HostGator just won out against Bluehost. Now what about if you're more advanced and want their most expensive plans? I'll compare that for you now. Things get more interesting here, where HostGator's top plan works out to be 57% cheaper than Bluehost for 3 years, and 58% cheaper for 1 year. You can see that HostGator wins on price hands down, but now that you know the percentage price difference, you can watch my next categories and see if the extra features Bluehost offers over HostGator is worth the extra money for your specific plans. But for this pricing category, I have to give 1 point to HostGator. Now let's go through and assess which hosting provider is actually easier to set up and use. This one is going to be tough because both Bluehost and HostGator have custom interface in the back ends, which are somewhat similar. Bluehost has a clean looking interface and is easy to navigate through to different sections on their back end. I just have a minor issue with them in that they tend to hide some free features and easily present the paid one instead, like for the free email account. If you navigate to the email and offers tab, you won't find the free option to create emails. Instead, you would have to navigate to the advanced section and create your free email account from their cPanel. Now, HostGator is pretty much exactly the same as Bluehost here. They have a very clean and responsive user interface, and they also have the same issue as Bluehost when trying to set up your email account. They too hide their free option in the cPanel and try to upsell you to purchase the paid version. Moving on to the WordPress installation, both hosting providers gives you the option for the custom one-click WordPress installation. However, I found Bluehost to be slightly easier and quicker to do the install, as you don't have to access your email account to retrieve your password like you have to on HostGator. I believe both Bluehost and HostGator are one of the best choices for beginners if you haven't created or hosted a website before. You'll be able to get your WordPress site up and running in less than 5 minutes without any technical knowledge or coding skills, thanks to their one-click WordPress installation, which both of them provide. Overall, this one was a very tight one, but I would have to give the point to Bluehost this time, as I think it is a little bit cleaner and easier for me to work on my site, and their WordPress install is more intuitive. First, let's start with a comparison of the speed performance test. I made sure to compare apples with apples by installing the same speed and image optimizer plugins and putting Cloudflare on both accounts to optimize it even further. So both these websites are pretty much as fast as you can get it without paying extras for it. My test result shows Bluehost to have a page load speed of 3.4 seconds on GT metrics, while HostGator only managed a load time of 3.9 seconds here. This means Bluehost is 13% faster than HostGator. Both companies only have data centers in the United States, so there shouldn't be any advantage in terms of global site speed between each other. If you're accessing your website from any location outside of the United States, the speed should decrease by roughly the same amount. Now, if you want more details on my tests or just want more in-depth review of Bluehost or HostGator, you can check the link in my description for that. The next thing we will compare is their uptime. Bluehost had a perfect 100% uptime, while HostGator only managed to produce a subpar result of 99.895%, which is way below my threshold of 99.95% and even HostGator's own 99.9% uptime guarantee. They failed big time here, while Bluehost was perfect. Overall, this was an easy win for Bluehost, as their page load speed is faster than HostGator, even though both are not that great and don't pass Google's standard 3-second load time. Bluehost also has proven to be a very reliable host with perfect uptime. Sadly, the same can't be said for HostGator, so an easy point to Bluehost on this one. Support. With regards to Bluehost customer support response time, their overall average over peak and off-peak periods was lightning quick, just 30 seconds. Same cannot be said for HostGator. Their response time was around 4 minutes and 20 seconds, which is still not too bad, but they're nowhere near as good as Bluehost. Now, in terms of the staff knowledge and helpfulness, this was also a clear win for Bluehost. For example, when I told both companies that I had a virus on my website and asked them to send me a malware report, Bluehost was able to do this for me immediately, and the whole process took around 10 minutes. But HostGator took almost 30 minutes and still could not give me the report. They had to refer me to their more technical staff by email and told me that I would receive a report later through this communication. This shows a clear difference on how both of their support teams work. So based on this, I would have to declare the overall winner in the customer support department to be Bluehost by a long shot and give them another point. Features. Now, in terms of features, this one would have to be an easy win for Bluehost, as they have all the features HostGator's offer and so much more. HostGator does, however, offer a nice handy feature, which is the free website migration if you're moving over from another hosting provider. Bluehost does not offer this, so just keep that in mind. The biggest and most important feature, which is critical for your website and is missing for HostGator, but not with Bluehost, is the automatic daily backups. Bluehost provides daily backup on your website for free on their more expensive plans. This is standard nowadays, and I believe every hosting provider should have one. So it's really disappointing to know that HostGator has not included this feature. Overall, this one is a no-brainer for me. Bluehost get another point easily for the features section. So after comparing these two hosting providers over 5 categories, Bluehost was a clear winner. They won 4 categories while HostGator only won 1. I don't think I can recommend HostGator over Bluehost in any situation, even though they may be slightly cheaper than Bluehost, but the small price difference is just not enough for the performance loss. Bluehost does not have the fastest speed, which isn't ideal, but with their solid uptime, it still makes them a reliable host which could be suitable for beginners. HostGator fails in both of these departments and provide very little features in their plans. I still think there are better options out there over these two hosting providers, and I'll let you know my pick at the end of the video. So do you like the level of detail I'm providing in my review? If so, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content that I release every week, just like this. Here's a quick question for you. Are you leaning more towards Bluehost or HostGator right now? And why? Let me know in the comments section below. This is a quick note regarding my special offer to you. If you decide to pick up Bluehost or HostGator through my link, just quickly send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I will send you access back to my course, right away. It's that simple. So now that you have decided on your hosting provider, it's time to fully build out your WordPress website. And this next video will help you do just that. But if you don't like either of these hosting options, then I recommend you watch this video for my number one recommendation on the hosting provider that I use. And I'll see you in the next video.